What's up everyone, I'm IterationFunk and today we're back in Exoria. There we go. Pia. I dried up some of the pufferfish since last time. Look at it. It's like, I really hope it's dead because it's not looking happy at all. You know, and we dry it. For some reason, sometimes it poisons us, so I guess it isn't the best food source in the world. We can smelt like the two first types into cooked fish, I think both. Yeah. But what do we do with the clownfish? I wonder if the clownfish would also prove poisonous to us. I'm gonna have to find out later, but we have protein solved and I actually ground up some wheat. So whenever we get hungry, I'm gonna use that so we can get our final buff here. I'm not sure where we left off. Let's see here. What do we need to do? We're gonna want to get into the crystallizing and stuff. Manually pouring the liquid is quite cumbersome. Yeah, I've read this quest text, I think. We're gonna do the hovering hourglass. Just gonna need some plates here. And a piece of glass. I think this is the recipe. There we go, one hovering hourglass. And let's take 4 sand with us. And I'm casting some more glass at the moment, so let's put this guy here. Just to make sure he pours every so often. And I made some more molds here because this guy is much quicker and versatile than the other casts, so I think I'm only gonna use this guy for like all of the different pores. I made some more iron. And man, iron is really scarce. I should really make some more strainers or get more warberry bushes. I don't know, but iron, we need a lot of iron, it seems. Glass isn't an issue though, so we have a lot of glass. We're gonna need this episode. What else? Let's read here. Now that I have sulfur, I guess from the strainers, I can make some sort of explosive material. If I contain the explosion in some special structure, I might be able to make some crystal shards. Okay, crystal shards. My plan is to make a casing and put the combustion heater in with some fuel and a trigger from the hourglass. I can ignite what is on top. We're probably gonna do buttons, I think. Tricky thing is to contain the explosion. I need to put some glass on the 4 sides to see what is inside, and then I can put a dropper on top which allows me to put the glass above the combustion heater without the heat blowing out. Also, just in case something goes wrong, I should encase the structure in some explosion resistant stone. Hardened stone is a bit expensive, so I will use concrete for now again. I don't think we need to encase it. These explosions aren't actual explosions. From all of my time spent with Skyresources too, I think it's not that bad. Now, how do we make the gunpowder? I'm interested. Because it's a part of progression. Niter? Sulfur? Coal? Okay. I think we can do that. Let's come over here. Actually, widened the path a bit here and made a little side area. Because we're gonna need space, I think. And I ran the dust through, so you can I think maybe I showed that last time, but you can run the dust through after you've run the ash through. So that just gives you crushed quartz and certus. So I have some certus, I have some... where is the other one? Quartz? It's down here. And I made some stiffened mesh. So I'm partly done with this other resources quest. Better meshes might give me some resources I would otherwise not be able to get, but other resources I might get at a lower chance instead. I have to do some tests which resource has which percentage chance to be gotten for each mesh. So, iron stiffened mesh, we can do that, but I think it's a bit expensive and I wanna preserve my iron, so if we could just hold off on that for just a second. But I guess I... Do we need the diamond mesh today? I'm not sure. We'll find out. But let's do the gunpowder. The gunpowder was niter and stuff, yeah. So where's my niter? It's up here. And some sulfur, and the last thing was these will work. Let's just make all of that, I think. Yeah, leave one piece of sulfur so we have some gunpowder. Now, a regular combustion chamber has a casing and a heater, then some sort of structure that contains the explosion. So we need to make the casing stone, which is a stone gear. Let's go up again. I think most of the things we need is up there. Let me grab one pulverized coal. I think I need it later. Yeah, we need it for the condensers. So I'll grab that as well. My legs weren't made for this. There's so much walking going on. This seems to be working fairly well though. Pouring whenever. And 5 second is a pretty good delay. Shouldn't cause much update lag. So, gunpowder. And we're gonna need both cobblestone and this. So, a casing. No, it's the stone. There we go. And I might need another of these for the condenser. I think we also unlock like iron casings, but it's... Oh, I did it again. It's a bit expensive, the iron casing. And I really want to be efficient with my iron right now. There we go. Then we need a combustion heater from Skyresources, which has a speed of 80% and is 100% efficient. We put this in, get a kit component, and I think it's this. Okay, that's the combustion heater. Then we need a dropper. Oh, it detected it. So a dropper is that. Yeah, it's a pretty easy recipe. I think this is altered. I think it's redstone in vanilla. There we go, lever. Then we're gonna need... Was it cobble? Yeah, I think it was cobble. There we go, dropper. And it wants us to do the crystal shards. Now, the combustion chamber only have one recipe because the alchemical gold is disabled, so we can only make crystal shards in the combustion chamber. So all of these things are never really gonna be relevant unless we want to be super efficient with our glass. Oh, it grew. Let's put it away. Let's come down here and try to make this a thing. And I'm gonna need some I'm gonna need some coal here. Maybe 64? I don't think we have mini coal. I feel like I've already tried that. Ow. I mean, it's a good thing that I take full damage because I still want to eat the bread here. So we could start by doing this, then we need a casing, put the combustion heater in, try to wrap this around. And I really like that a lot of clear glass is used here because it doesn't really break the same way other glass breaks. And let's do this maybe. There we go. Oh no, rocks. Not the rocks. That's gonna clog up my inventory. And I want two buttons. Button. And we just give you some charcoal. And then we put this in the dropper. We can hit the button. We get some crystal shards. Cool. And as you can see, it didn't really hurt any surrounding blocks, so we don't need to do that. Unless I'm missing something. So let's try for a stack. This will last us a long time because there isn't that many recipes in the condenser either. Not much of the actual base mod is used, which I'm totally fine with. So the next thing here We can do some things like automated explosions, but this quest probably takes around 40 iron in itself, so we're gonna skip that. We could grab our crucible inserter. I should also try to automate the crucible. My design is an upgraded hopper that will only drop if there's enough space in the crucible. We have one of those already, but we're gonna have to do the iron condenser and the fluid dropper and put that like over here. And I think the fluid dropper is pretty easy. Oh yeah, it's super easy. But only the iron condenser. And that doesn't really take that much iron. And that's why I brought the rised coal here. Do that. Excellent. And then a dropper. Then we can grab you. I think we actually want to... I don't need you here right now. We have plenty of water. Those two are done. We can use this contraption to make burnium and coal, which I'm guessing we're gonna use for something. Better piping among other things. How much iron do I have left? 27. Neat. Then we might upgrade our mesh too, because we're gonna need to do that for some other resources. Okay, so I want a chest that the condenser auto outputs to, and it needs to go under, so I need to start with that, I think. Let's grab a chest. I have my fire starter. I need one or two ash blocks. Let's just grab some real quick here. And yeah, I got more grass here. Slowly taking over the world with green stuff. That's really pretty. There we go, that should suffice. And let's use the K key. Oh, that's so nice. Let's go down to our humble basement. Not so humble anymore, it's rather large. Let's, so you'll go here, and let's try to align you, I guess. And iron condenser. It might be in our best interest to get the condenser as efficient as possible soon. This guy isn't as important. Just grab some more here. So I'm gonna need some sort of their way, I guess. Do maybe this. I'm gonna do ash block. Ash block. This roof is a bit... I should get roof. I need more space. Let's get more space. And I'll fix this up later. I just need some... little bit of more space here. So the other sides could be... Oh, good, I left to this stuff. Let me just do that. We'll light these on fire. And for now we'll just do one crucible. And since it's only one now, let's maybe put it behind. But okay, I'll just do this. So ash block, we're gonna light that on fire. And crucible, inserter. And we're gonna need another fluid dropper down here. Let me do that. And I don't have a crafting table down here, I think, so no mats to make one. So we'll just go up here, make another fluid dropper, might even fetch some more glass. Ow, 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 ow. Get rid of this guy. There we go. And now we just need to place the fluid dropper here. Neat. Then I just need to insert the shards here so that they will make the liquid in the crucible. Then that will be outputted to the droppers, which will push the fluid down here. And that's contained here, so the recipes in a condenser here, you can see this slot represents the block or fluid that's above the condenser, so we can use either crystal fluid or stone. Now, I think all of the alchemical dusts are disabled, so the stone recipes aren't really gonna work for us, but we can do burnium with the burnium dust. We can also get diamond from diamond dust, I guess. And we have emeralds, prismarine crystals, surtus quartz. You know, we get all this from sifting, which is quite neat. So if we would like the coal, for example, or let's start with burnium. Put it here. It's gonna consume one, and since it's 0.7 output, one piece of burnium dust is not enough to get us a burnium unless we have enough efficiency. Just 20% extra isn't enough, I think. We would need like 135% maybe to actually be able to get one burnium per dust. Now, since these are pretty slow, or I guess the condenser is pretty slow, this one crucible will keep up with it. So let's grab this. Maybe even grab our coal here. We should be happy with two. And I'm gonna take this out whenever this is finished. And switch to coal so we can complete the quest. Any second now. There we go. Let's dump that out because it's not gonna be any useful to us. Let's do polarized coal, and we get plenty of polarized coal. I'll just let that run, and that's a bit faster. Let's see. Yeah, the process takes 10 seconds. We have coal, we have burnium, that's the quest done. Nice, let's put that back in. Now, Caminite. Interesting thing, I think I have everything on me for that. We need clay, dust piles and sulfur. I only have one sulfur, I'm glad I saved that. So I think it's something like this. We get 4 Caminite. We can go smelt those up into bricks. And then we can do the bricks. And I need to get some more ash going because I used all of our sulfur on gunpowder. Which I'm not sure was the best idea. It might have set us back a bit. Let's put that in here. So by accident I discovered a blend not well known to me. I will call it Caminite. I wonder if it will be useful besides looking pretty. So we're gonna need 4 of these. And we can combine that into bricks, and I think we get the ancient codex, which is the manual for embers. Excellent. There we go. Caminite bricks. Detect claim. So this is one of our first books. And I'm not sure anything here is gonna be relevant to us right away. At least we have it, so we can research ember stuff. I'm gonna need to do this, and I'm pretty sure I have enough iron for it. Not sure how many I want. I have some flint meshes down here that I'll upgrade. I'll probably grab 2 of these to upgrade to iron. Then I can upgrade one of them to diamond later. I just hope I have enough iron. You're out of sand. Let's stop you from grabbing all of our charcoal for now. So the iron meshes, and let me put away some stuff that I really don't need on me anymore. There we go. Now these meshes can be upgraded with iron mesh, which is made by 6 pieces of strand with a Gallagher. So we're gonna need Oh, we need to make this into plates, I guess. I wonder if it's fast to smelt the actual ingots down again, because the rocks take some time. And I just drained all of the... That's not good. Let's give you that back. Smelt this down. How many iron plates do we need per mesh? We need 8 mesh. And we get 8 per plate. So we get 1.2 iron mesh per strand craft. So we're gonna need maybe 16 iron, or I guess 14. I'm betting 14 will be somewhere around where we need to be. That might take a while to smelt up though. I mean, the rocks are just one nugget each. So this might be fine. We'll be back when this is smelted up so I can get going on those iron meshes. I think we're ready. I have 14 plates, so let's get to the next step of our iron plan here. Let's make all of these. And I think it's like this, yeah? And no, it's the Gallagher. Where are you? You are here. Put this away. Gallagher. And we can do... 1 second, I just need to divide all of this. And... I guess we'll do 16 for now. And let's see what I do with these. Maybe I can use them for something else. So we do this, put that in the middle, and we get the iron stift. Pretty neat. Can't wait to try those out. Now I have some dust that I brought with me. Let's go down and sift that. Hopefully we can get the last pieces of the puzzle for this quest. Let's do this and yeah, it only divides to the iron stiffened when I do this. That's good. We're gonna go through all of this and hopefully we'll get the diamond, little diamond charge we need. Oh, we got one tiny pile, tiny. We still get crushed quartz. Okay, two. Not too shabby. I think we might be able to make 1 or 2 diamonds from this. This is gonna be great. There we go. I did some extra ash while waiting for the iron plates to finish, so I got a little bit of more dust while sifting, so I could get up to 13 dusts of 13 tiny pile of diamond dust. So that's gonna be hopefully. Oh no. That's gonna be at least 3 diamonds, maybe? But yeah, we need a crushed black quartz too, and I think that's from ash blocks in these, so I'm gonna have to do ash blocks too. And I saved some extra ash blocks, because I knew I was gonna need them here. Let me get some black quartz. I'm not sure if we'll use the black quartz for tools, or... Oh, there we go. We might wanna... exchange some of these sieves, automatic sifters, with the so that they have iron stiffened mesh instead, because that's gonna be getting some of the crushed black quartz passively would be nice, because you know we do want that for tools and stuff. It's a pretty good material. There we go. That was all of the extra ash I had. Let's put some dusts away that we don't really need right now. Like all of this stuff. We got 7 of the crushed black quartz. And we get 1.8 and we have 121 efficiency. So this might be 14 black quartz. That's not too bad. And let's see here, gems. Yeah, we need to unlock this quest going down. We need to do this. So we need a diamond. And I think we need to flake that diamond. Where's flaking? Here, inward flaking. We get 3 flake diamond, and then each of those are 2. So we should, in theory, get... For each diamond, we should get 1 diamond stiffened mesh. Let's exchange this. Are we out of... Yeah, we're out of crystal. So we're gonna have to get some more clear glass. And I noticed something funny. I'm not sure if that's intended, but I... Like, if you check the log here, these are all from my testing world. These items that I have given to myself, but when I'm in this world, they show up. So I'm not sure what that is about, really. Do they share a log? You shouldn't share a log. That's a bit weird for me. Do I have some extra clear glass we're gonna need? Let's do another stack of crystal glass down here. Put that in. And grab a few. There we go, 64. Put that in. Let's dump the previous thing here. Let's put that in. Hopefully it will keep up. If we run out of crystal fluid while doing the diamond, I'm gonna be angry, because that's a kind of a rookie mistake, I guess. Let's get rid of these guys. I don't think I need a ladder, really. As long as I can reach you. Oh, a diamond. And we barely got one, so we're... You know, the efficiency for these are 0.99, so we need like 101% efficiency to get one diamond per dust. It's a bit cheeky, but you know, it's not hard to get that efficiency. And there we go. Two diamonds. We'll get three diamonds. Let's start flaking these, I guess. Diamonds! Yeah. Always love when I get diamonds. Let's go punch this rock for a while. So maybe we can get, you know, a flake. I wonder if we need to do this on obsidian or some hard material, because this isn't really working. Now that I can crystallize the diamond, I might improve the mesh a third time for some more rare resources. Diamonds needs to be flaked on obsidian. Oh. I mean... I guess we'll go find some obsidian then. And let's grab some extra water, just so we can cover up all of the lava. Because if we lose some diamond flakes in lava, I'll be an unhappy funk. Jumping over here. I think this is done, so I need to... Yeah, I need to collect. Need to collect this later. Here we are. And let's get rid of all of this nasty lava on the surface. I think that's all of it. And let's flake it then, I guess. Consumed one. Where did it... No, where did the flakes go? I don't trust this anymore. Let's do it over here. Oh, I got robbed on one, I think. This is... Weren't we supposed to get... three? Like, wait, what? I'm not sure what I saw. Oh, that's... heartbreaking. Let's go back up. We can't complete this quest, but yeah, that's a bummer, because I'm gonna need at least two more diamonds, and I'm not sure I can get that. Maybe I'll farm some ash and we'll be back when I have two more diamonds, just so we can make one mesh. And while we wait for me to do all the heavy lifting on the grinding, let's put these in and get as many crushed black quartz as possible. So I'll be back in a bit, see if I can't get two more diamonds. I'm gonna need to... I mean, I have some extra dust, but I'm gonna need a lot more ash, so see you in a bit. And we're back. That was a lot of work, but I got some more diamonds, and I actually got 6 diamonds, but I went over to that place and, you know, I flaked 2 diamonds and I only got 1 point, and the other one got entirely consumed. So I think I think JEI is a bit weird here. It changes value after each time. I think maybe it will set the chance on flakes to your character or something. It's a bit weird. Let's just flake and hope. Like, how many? We got one, okay. And if we would use that now, it's just 1 point. I swore, I'm gonna need to look at that footage, but yeah, okay. What does it say now? Still one. Still one. There we got four. I'm pretty sure we can get two. Nothing. Six. Come on. The last, if this one fails, I'm gonna... Oh. I'm not sure what's going on here. Like... Yeah, I'm really not sure. So we can grab one of these, I guess, and then... We have 8 points, so we should be able to make that now. And... I have some more dust here, because we're gonna need to sift for emeralds. I'm closing in on a wrapping up point here, but I would like to at least prepare for getting to the, like, core of the planet. Let's see. Wrap you around here. Diamond stiffen mesh. Cool, all done here. Then we just need an emerald. Which we sift for, put in the condenser. While working towards getting those diamonds, I got some more crushed quartz and processed them all, so we have 51. I'm probably gonna do the armor and maybe a pickaxe, because I think there's nasty things down in the planet core. Let's just grab some dust here and hope we can get some diamonds, and we... Now we're just constrained to one, so this will take a while. I'll be back in a minute. Well then, I sifted like 4 stacks or something, and let's look at the loot table real quick here. So tiny pile of emerald dust is a 6% drop chance from dust. Diamond dust is 10. So it's just 4 less, but we got one tiny pile of emerald dust. 15 tiny pile of diamond dust. Like, this ratio is... sometimes I'm just super unlucky. We're gonna have to wrap up the episode here. Let's just go up and celebrate. We have black quartz and make the armor, I guess. We get the helmet. If I can actually do the correct recipe. We can do legs. And chest. Feet. Haha, armor. And one more step up to actually find some sticks. And there we go. That's all for this episode, folks. We did the sieves. We got, you know, upgraded the sieves. We did the condenser. We did the combustion chamber. We're progressing nicely here. We did so much sifting. So much sifting. And I don't really see the end to the sifting, but, you know, we'll get to that at some point. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed the episode. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you next time here in Exoria.